While some who were interned within the Japanese internment camps during World War II due to the attacks on Pearl Harbor do not want to talk about their experiences inside the camp, the following people are kind enough to share their stories that many do not know. Actions the U.S. government took after the attacks on Pearl Harbor.
Everything from Japan got burned because they didn't want it to be here so that people would look at it and say, oh, they're Japanese citizens, so they're going to be more loyal to Japan.
Grandpa Ogata had five farms altogether in Orange County. So, but when the war came, then I was all taken away.
You know, you can take away anybody's possessions. You can take away my clothes, my phone, my car, da da da. Really, as a human being, the only thing I'm left with is my dignity. And once you take that away, then you pretty much take a human and make them not a human anymore. And there was a lot of people that felt that way at that time, that they were dehumanized. And not even, you know, a human being of an enemy like Japan or maybe an enemy of Germany. But at the very least, you should be treated as a human, as a decent human being. And there's a lot of people that weren't. So I'm angry for that, and I'm sad for that, even though I don't have any friends or family that were part of that. It's just part of something that I feel. But it's not like I carry any type of hatred or anything.
How their lives were shaped inside the camps that affected their lives outside the camps.
They had rice, but they didn't have regular food. Things that they were used to for a while. So they would get, the only thing I remember them talking about was, because they thought it was really gross, was they had peaches on rice.
My mom said that when they used to give them rice and horse meat in the concentration camp, she goes, it was bad. You know, the barracks were, everything, all the floors were wooden and really dusty in the desert, and they had to clean up. And so they were, like I said, I guess when you're young, you don't really feel the full effects of what my grandmother, and especially my grandfather, being separated for those years during the war. So
the government took away their possessions and tried to pay them back with money out of guilt.
But again, it was about fear. So, but my grandmother, an awful thing. As a matter of fact, it took 50 years for the United States to even publicly apologized to them, and they gave them $20,000 as reparations. Mm-hmm. My grandmother just took that check and gave it to a charity. She said, I don't want it, so.
Yeah, the money, whatever money they got, I think it was 20-something thousand, whatever, that was whatever, but the more, what meant more to them was the apology.
The way the camps changed the Japanese Americans' lives forever.
So after Pearl Harbor got bombed, they were prominent business people, and so the people that the American government or the military were watching and were suspicious of being maybe Japanese spies were people that were prominent, meaning they had high social ranking within the society in Hawaii. And my grandparents, being that they were business owners, they were deemed as that. So they brought my grandfather in for questioning after the bombing. I don't know how far after, maybe even months after, just to interrogate him to see if he was a spy.
My mom said that when they used to give him rice and horse meat in the concentration camp, she goes, it was bad. You know, the barracks were, everything, all the floors were wooden and really dusty in the desert, and they had to clean up. And so they were, like I said, I guess when you're young, you don't really feel the full effects of what my grandmother, and especially my grandfather, being separated for those years during the war. So.
How the government worked after the internment of the Japanese Americans.
So after Pearl Harbor got bombed, they were prominent business people. And so the people that the American government or the military were watching and were suspicious of being maybe Japanese spies were people that were prominent, meaning they had high social
You know, just be, it's mind-blowing to me. And when we were growing up, my three brothers and myself, and my mother would tell us these stories, we'd always say, why didn't you fight back? Or why didn't you run away? Or why didn't you? And I said, no, you know, this is our government's telling us to do this. And so we did it. It wasn't until 1996 when my brother, who is now our superintendent, But when he was a teacher, he had read something about how other high schools had allowed Japanese American internees graduate with their high school class. So he asked the superintendent at the time if our mother could also be one of those graduates. And they sent out letters to every Japanese American student at that time to come and walk with the class in 1996. So that was very special. So my mother actually got to graduate, and that was pretty special.
First grade, my teacher, we were doing a little art project, and there were like these little clay things. And you know, first grade, you're about 6 years old, 7 years old, kid. And I remember I was very excited to show my, because it was like a little clay thing, right? And they were drawing, and then you were going to paint them. And I remember I was excited to show whatever I created to my teacher, Miss Dunning. And I ran up to see, for her to see what I made, right? And the kid had his drawing, and it was kind of on his desk, but it was overlapping. So when I went to see the teacher, it knocked it off, right? And his broke. And I felt, the teacher blamed me, and she said that, you know, you Oriental people are, your parents should be ashamed of you.
Had to then try and figure out how we were going to make sure that people knew that we weren't the enemy, like my family wasn't the enemy. So.
What happened, happened. So forget about that. Put it behind us, put it behind you. But it's being Japanese, I always had somebody who said, hey, we're in Pearl Harbor. It would strike a chord in me because of the ignorance of that phrase, you know. But as I grew older, I learned that, gosh, they probably are one of the, if not the most respected people, because of their integrity, honesty, and work ethic. So, yeah, I'm proud to be Japanese, but I'm American first.